CES 2026 is officially over. And if there's one takeaway from this year's event, it's this. AI is everywhere, but the industry is still figuring out how to make it matter. Hello everyone, Papa PC here for a full wrap-up of this 2026 edition of the CES in Las Vegas. From silicon giants to PC manufacturers and peripheral brands, CES 2026 wasn't about one revolutionary product, it was about a transition toward AI-assisted computing, more power-hungry hardware and an ecosystem that's evolving fast. Let's break it down, day by day, focusing on what actually matters for PC gamers, creators and enthusiasts. NVIDIA opened CES 2026 with a keynote that made its priorities very clear. The spotlight was on AI infrastructure with the unveiling of NVIDIA's next-generation Rubin computing platform, combining new GPUs with the Vera CPU. This platform targets data centers, robotics, autonomous systems, and large-scale AI workloads. Gaming wasn't the main focus, but it wasn't ignored fully. Nothing about a potential Super 5000 series, but a strong rumor about a re-release of the 2021's RTX 3060 to dodge the RAM crisis. Okay then. NVIDIA introduced DLSS 4.5, refining ray reconstruction, reducing image instability, and further improving performance at high resolutions. It's another step forward, making ray tracing more accessible without massive performance loss. I still have to try that on the freshly received RTX 5070 Ti. Intel followed with a keynote centered on personal computing. The headline announcement was Core Ultra Series 3, codenamed Panther Lake, built on Intel's advanced 18A process node. Panther Lake is primarily aimed at laptops with improvements in efficiency, battery life, and local AI acceleration. Intel framed this as the real starting point of the AI PC, where everyday applications, not just creative tools, can benefit from AI processing without relying entirely on cloud services. AMD closed day one with a balanced but mostly AI-centered confident keynote. On the enterprise side, AMD unveiled the MI FrontRidge Series AI accelerators, targeting hyperscalers and large AI deployments. For consumers, AMD expanded its Ryzen AI lineup, pushing local AI capabilities further into laptops and desktops. Many guests were on stage, including OpenAI's co-founder and president. Gamers weren't left out, at least not fully, with the announcement of the Ryzen 7 9850X3D, continuing AMD's strategy of using 3D V-Cache to deliver class-leading gaming performance. MSI delivered one of the most visually striking booths of CES 2026. The centerpiece was the MSI RTX 5090 32GB Lightning Z, an overpowered machine marking the return of the legendary Lightning series. This extreme graphics card features advanced liquid cooling, a heavily customized PCB, a dual BIOS, and even an integrated 8-inch display, making it as much a showcase of engineering as a performance product. MSI also refreshed its gaming laptop lineup, including the Stealth 16, AI Plus, and Crosshair 16 Max HX, pairing Intel Core Ultra processors with RTX 50 series GPUs. On the display side, MSI introduced the MPG 341 CQR QD OLED X36. That's a long name. A 34-inch ultra-wide gaming monitor with a 360Hz refresh rate, highlighting MSI's growing focus beyond just PCs. ASUS leaned heavily into innovation under its ROG brand, highlights included the ROG Zephyrus Duo, featuring dual OLED displays, and the ROG Flow Z13KJP, a limited edition gaming tablet design in collaboration with Kojima Productions. ASUS also showcased high-end gaming laptops, next-generation gaming monitors, and experimental hardware like AR gaming glasses, reinforcing ASUS' willingness to push unconventional designs. Gigabyte used CES 2026 to emphasize its AI-forward strategy. Under the ASUS brand, Gigabyte showcased a very interesting design RTX 5090 GPU. Basically, it looks like a boombox from my childhood on one side, more like a stove on the other. Like it or not, at least, they try to do something different. They also introduced gaming laptops optimized for AI workloads and compact AI-focused desktops like AI Top Atom, designed to run large language models locally. Gigabyte also presented its Gigapod modular AR infrastructure, signaling ambitions that extend well beyond traditional consumer hardware. Day 3 shifted attention toward the ecosystem surrounding PCs. Samsung and LG showcased next-generation OLED and QD OLED gaming monitors, offering higher refresh rates, improved brightness, and better burn-in protection. ASUS ROG complemented this with mini-LED and OLED displays aimed to both competitive gamers and content creators. Storage and memory were another clear focus on day 3. Samsung and SanDisk, among others, all showcased faster NVMe SSDs and higher capacity storage solutions designed for modern game libraries and creator workloads. SanDisk officially introduced its Optimus SSD lineup, consolidating former WD Black and WD Blue products into a single tiered brand targeting gamers, professionals, and creators. Samsung highlighted next-generation PCIe Gen 5 SSDs, including compact models designed for high-end laptops, alongside early previews of LPDDR6 memory aimed at boosting performance and efficiency in future systems. Behind the scenes, controller manufacturers like Phison demonstrated new PCIe Gen 5 controllers, signaling that even faster SSDs are on the way. Memory brands like Patriot followed suit with higher speed DDR5 kits designed to pair with the latest CPUs from Intel and AMD. But the sad news is that most of us will not be able to buy them anyway, as the prices of the RAM keep its mountain climbing. Power requirements were impossible to ignore at CES 2026. Thermaltek showcased the Tough Power AX 3000 watts, underlining just how power-hungry next-generation systems are becoming. Not less than 4 12VH power connectors are included, delivering 600 watts each. Alongside it, Thermaltek presented its Golden Track PSU design, allowing users to replace modular connector plates instead of the entire power supply, a concept aimed at flexibility and reducing electronic waste. MSI also introduced its new GPU Safeguard and GPU Safeguard Plus features on next-generation MAG and MPG power supplies. These PSUs actively monitor the 12VH power connector for abnormal current loads or prolonged power spikes, triggering audible alerts, and on MPG models, on-screen warnings via MSI Center to prevent connector overheating and GPU damage. If the issue isn't resolved, the PSU can automatically shut down the system to protect the hardware. We'll see that in practice. One of the most memorable moments of CES didn't come from a product launch. On the Dell side, new XPS laptops were introduced, but on January 7th, Kevin Terwilliger, head of product at Dell, made a strikingly honest statement about AI in consumer PCs. A very different approach if you compare this quote with last year's interview. That comment perfectly summed up CES 2026. The industry is fully committed to AI, PC lost its meaning, but consumers still care most about performance, battery life, reliability, and price. CES 2026 wasn't about one breakthrough moment, it was about alignment. NVIDIA is building the AI infrastructure of the future, and for the first time in 5 years, no new GPU announced. Intel is redefining laptops around efficiency and local AI. No mention about the expected Arc B770 GPU either. AMD is scaling AI from servers to gaming PCs, beside of a short interlude to introduce the Ryzen 7 9850X3D. Not much to go on. But CES 2026 also reminded us of something important. Technology only matters if users are asking for it, understand and benefit from it. The next year will decide whether AI becomes a true selling point or just another checkbox. It was Papa PC. I hope you enjoyed this full video about the most important relevant news for computer fans. I'll see you soon.